come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I will find out starting in today's game between the Cincinnati Bearcats and the Virginia Cavaliers.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Cavaliers looking at a very capable opponent tonight, Dick. What are their keys to victory, do you think?
If I'm on a bench, Brad, my keys would be simple. Number one, the point guard has to take control of the game, and he has to dictate the tempo and the pace. Secondly, beware of turnovers. Protect the basketball. You want to minimize the amount of free possessions that you give to the opposition. And finally, if you win the glass, baby, and you'll own the boards, you'll win the game.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. He tries a jump hook.
That's every waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking the shot when you make that turn.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. Number 45 takes the pass. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. For two. In and out. Here's a flash from the high post. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Lost some ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Passed on the guy in the post to go the other way. Trying to feed inside. With the fake. Tries for two. Doesn't go. He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Tries a three. No luck finding the basket the last few trips down court, Dick.
What they need are some easy layups or a couple of nice putbacks.
Turns it over. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. On the dribble, gives it up. The center with the ball. With a little baby hook.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
High post flashes for the opportunity. He pump fakes. There they come with a double team to stop it. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Number 43 gets the ball. Now the high screen. Goes up for two. They still don't score. He's got a high post flasher. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Gave it up. The center takes the feed. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
He's got the post flashing if he wants it. They look to get it to the inside. There's a double team waiting there.
Turnover City now always nearing the gate. Any offense.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. He takes the shot. Goes. Here's a flash from the post up high. Way out on top, controlling the ball.
Let's see the replay on that one.
Number 44 is pretty fired up and excited.
Yeah, no kidding, partner. When you have some success, you start to gain some confidence.
He gets the shot to fall. The ball goes out of play. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
The shooting guard gets the pass. He attempts the three, makes it.
Roll that one back.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Kicks it out.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Down in the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He's got a nice shot fake. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Trying to go inside.
Blocks the shot. Both teams looking to get things going here.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
On the dribble, gives it up. Violation, 3 seconds.
Can't nap in a lane like that.
Kick it back outside. Shoots it. Gets it to go. On the outside, trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Fakes it. He does the sweet fake shot. Kicks it out. Number 44 with the fake. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Got the high pick. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
He'll shoot two. He hits it. Both.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, MBN.
Gave it up. Dumps it in. Here's a double team. 10 on the shot clock.
Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Tries for two. You betcha. Looking for a good shot. Entry pass in the paint. Perfectly executed. Moving it around the perimeter. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
They'll work it around the arc. Intercepted. They work the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. Picked off. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They work it around the perimeter.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
The post flashes up high if he wants it. Here's a nice face up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked him and took it to the basket. Only one basket away from the crowd being absolutely thrilled. Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Brad, I'm afraid to hear this crowd. If they can get a stop on this possession. There's the trap.
Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession. Off the rim and no good. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
On the outside, gave it up. He's got some room.
Gotta take some pride on a defensive end.
The shot won't fall. Good. The momentum is on their side, and everything is falling into place. Their body language, Dick, says it all.
Hey, hey, why not? It's a team sport, right?
At the half, the Bearcats are trailing by two. It's been a tight one thus far, Mr. Vitale. What play do you think set the tone here tonight?
Hey, Brad, when you look back at the first half, you have to consider this three ball, which set the tone for how the first half was going to go.
Let's get back down to the action where it looks like the two teams are all set to start the second half. Cincinnati just couldn't seem to stop turning the ball over in that first half, Dick.
Hey, if you ask me, these guys haven't clued on the magnitude of his game yet. They need to take care of the ball from here on in, or they have no shot, and they'll be running lots of laps tomorrow in practice.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. They've got a player spotting up on the three. Goes up for two. Knocks it down. Got a man in high post. That wide stance and the drop step.
I tell you, it's all about angles, and you can utilize that drop step. It's like a reverse pivot move.
For two.
Up. Easy one.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. The Cavaliers have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
Number 30 fakes the shot. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
High post flashes for the ball handler. The center gets the pat.
Ooh, look at the shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops. Steal, go up the other way, get a layup.
Way out on top, controlling the ball, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Great double team, really explosive.
Number 44 with the foul. First team foul. They come with a double team to stop it. The point guard receives the pass. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect. So they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
The Cavaliers will step to the line for the first time. He hits the first shot. Second one is no good. He grabs the rebound. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Stolen away. Fast break opportunity here. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
Nice fake. Now they work it around the perimeter. Working it around the perimeter. And a momentary look from three-point land.
That's spacing.
The shooting guard gets the ball. 10 seconds to put up a shot. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Tries for two and off the mark. He shoots from long range. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Watch out, the five-second count is getting close, Brad.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
On the dribble, gives it up. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
They work the perimeter. Steals the pass. There's a high screen. He looks for the bomb. Cincinnati have gotten themselves into a bit of a rhythm on offense, Dick. They're really on a nice run right here. On the outside. Picks off the lazy pass.
The game is changing, Brad. These days, guys are consistently playing above the rim.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Picks off the pass. For the bucket. Scorches the net. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love that. got them both. Gave it up. Great defense. The power forward takes the feed. And he scores it off the glass. On the outside. In the paint. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
From downtown. Off the rim and no good. The power forward receives the ball. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Rejected out of there.
Poor job on the offensive end. Great job defensively rotating to the basketball.
Goes up for two. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The shooting guard handles the pass. The trigger rims out. The point guard handles the feed. For two.
Gotta make that baby have a wide open angle, have a chance to lay it on the glass for easy deuce.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
The kick out. Number 52 picks up the foul. Second team foul. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Momentary look from three-point land. Now they work it around the perimeter. They'll work it around the arc. Goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
What a terrific job on a defense to beat him in the spot, Mr. Nessler.
Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nessler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Off the rim and no good. Just a matter, Dick, isn't it, a clock management here?
I'll tell you, it's time to start fouling in order to stop the clock.
And yet another foul. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Nobody likes this part of the game, and the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul.
Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
makes his second shot. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
We'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
The kick out. He fires away. He gets the bucket to fall. Shot clock is dead. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. He'll visit the charity stripe. He missed it.
Gotta get one on this possession, baby.
Looking for a good shot. He goes with a baby hook. Can't get the shot to go. Oh, what a hard screen there.
A little two-man game there, Brad.
All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Cincinnati came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I'll tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm